back to MSR Master Vision YouTube channel. Today we discuss about female reproductive system. What are the parts which are present in the female reproductive system? Parts of female reproductive system. Parts which are present in the female reproductive system. Yes, the first part name is, yes, what is the first part? A pair of ovaries. A pair of ovaries. A pair of ovaries present in the female reproductive system. Next, a pair of fallopian tube, a pair of fallopian tubes. Next, is one uterus. Next, vagina. Yes, vagina. So these are the parts present in the female reproductive system. The first part name is a pair of ovaries. Yes, the second part name is a pair of fallopian tubes. Yes, the third part name is uterus. Next, the fourth part name is vagina. So these are the parts which are present in the female reproductive system. So now we'll discuss about one by one. First we'll take ovaries. Here, how many ovaries is there? Here one ovary is there and here another ovary is there. So in the female reproductive system, how many ovaries is there? In the female reproductive system, mainly two ovaries is there. Yes, this is one and this is second one. So two ovaries which are present in the female reproductive system. Inside the ovary, what is there? Cellular bubble-like structures is there. Inside the ovary, cellular bubble-like structures is there. These cellular bubble-like structures we call as graafian follicles. What we can say, these cellular bubble-like structures we call as graafian follicles. Graafian follicles, then it grows in size. So when the graafian follicles grows in size, inside the graafian follicle, cavity is formed. Yes, this cavity is filled with a fluid. So here, whenever the graafian follicles mature, so these graafian follicles rupture and releases a ovum. So the process of rupturing of graafian follicle and release ovum, we call as ovulation. So this is about ovaries. Now we can discuss about fallopian tubes. In the female reproductive system, how many fallopian tubes is there? In the female reproductive system, this is one fallopian tube, this is another fallopian tube. So these two are fallopian tubes which are in the female reproductive system. So the fallopian tube extending from ovaries to uterus. Here, what is happening when the ovary releases ovum? That process we call as ovulation. After ovulation, the ovum enters into the widened funnel-like structure, that is fallopian tube. Then it is passing along with the fallopian tube. In the fallopian tube, whenever the ovum passing through the fallopian tube, at the time the sperm cell fuses with ovum, then it forms zygote. So that is we call as fertilization. So in the female reproductive system, where the fertilization takes place? So in the female reproductive system, fertilization takes place in the fallopian tube. Then we can get a zygote. So after the formation of zygote, zygote undergoes several mitotic divisions and it gives a solid ball like structures. Then it is passing down to the fallopian tube. So this is about a fallopian tube. Now we discuss about uterus. So this is the part of uterus. It is a inverted pear shaped structure. So uterus, it is a inverted pear shaped structure. The inner wall of the uterus we called as endometrium. Soon after the menstrual cycle, the endometrium is ready to receive the embryo. So for receiving embryo, the endometrium thickness is increased to receive the embryo. If the fertilization does not take place, this endometrium disintegrates and comes out in the form of menstrual fluid through vagina. If the fertilization takes place, the endometrium thickness is continuing and it is ready to receive the embryo. After the formation of zygote undergoes several mitotic divisions. After mitotic divisions, it gives solid ball-like structures. These solid ball-like structures are passing down through the fallopian tube. Then it reaches to the inner layer of endometrium. Okay, so whenever the solid ball-like structures reaches to the endometrium can receive the embryo. and it sinks in the walls of endometrium. This is we called as implantation. If the fertilization does not take place, the endometrium disintegrate and it comes out in the form of menstrual fluid. Then it is passing through the cervix, to vagina, to it will come out. So this is about female reproductive system. Uterus, it is a inverted pear-shaped structure. Right. Yes, the solid ball-like structure sinks in the wall of endometrium. That is we called as implantation. So if the fertilization does not take place at the time, the endometrium, it will disintegrate and it comes out in the form of menstrual fluid. Then it is passing through the cervix, to vagina. So this is about a female reproductive system. So in the female reproductive system, a pair of ovaries is there, and a pair of fallopian tubes is there, and uterus is there, and vagina is there. The examination, they will ask diagram based question. See here. So if you observe this diagram, yes, the labeled part A is there, and the labeled part B is there, and the labeled part C is there. So based on this diagram, they will ask diagram based question. Yes, in that diagram, what do the labeled part A, B, C indicate? So A indicates the fallopian tube and B indicates ovary. Next, C indicates uterus. They will ask another question. So in the female reproductive system, where the implantation takes place? In the uterus part, implantation takes place. Next, the third question. In the female, in the above picture or in the given picture, where the fertilization takes place? In the A part, in the fallopian tube, fertilization takes place. So, they are asking questions for examination. Please like, share and subscribe my channel. Thank you. Have a nice day. Bye.